Hello, what's up, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome to Love Through Living. This is where I talk everything mind, body, soul, and that encompasses a whole bunch of things from self-love to health, and I go for plant-based health and minimalism and spiritual practices and just a whole cacophony of awesome self-optimization things. And today, what I'm going to talk about is minimalism. I'm gonna break this video into three parts. We're gonna go over what minimalism is, how I. Okay, I don't even. What are you even focused on? Thank you. How I personally became a minimalist, and then also just a few tips and hacks that I've gathered along the way that have really helped me be able to maintain this sort of mentality. What is minimalism? Great fucking question. I actually don't know the textbook definition of minimalism, but from my understanding, it is when you have only the essentials. Basically, you have what you need. Let me see. Let me ask my computer. What is minimalism? A trend in sculpture and painting that arose in the 1950s. Not the noun. Is it a noun? An avant-garde movement in music characterized by the repetition of very short phrases which change gradually, producing a hypnotic effect. Really? What is minimalism? That's not the minimalism I'm looking for. Okay, what is the minimalist lifestyle? Minimalism is intentionality. Is that a word? It is marked by clarity, purpose, and intentionality. At its core, minimalism is the intentional promotion of the things we most value and the removal of everything that distracts us from it. It is a life that forces intentionality. Okay. That's basically what I was getting at. Yeah, and intentionality is a word. Word of the day, intentionality. It feels quite yellow in here. Is that better? What is minimalism? So I've never looked up the definition before. That was actually harder to do than I would have expected. But for me, minimalism is only keeping the things in my life that are valuable to me, that bring my life value. And this doesn't mean that, you know, you have to get rid of absolutely everything and only have like the barest essentials so that way you look the most minimal. It's not about how you look, it's about how you feel. It's about basically getting rid of all the clutter in your life. So that way you can see and touch and appreciate all the little things that genuinely bring your life value. Whether these are certain clothing items or even sentimentals, furniture pieces. You know, I realized through my journey how many extra furniture pieces we had that their sole purpose ended up being a place to just hold stuff that I didn't know where to put it, stuff that I didn't really need or want to think about. I'll put it in that drawer. I'll put it on under that side table. Anyway, the whole nutshell of what minimalism is downsizing the material items. I guess it doesn't have to be just material. This is hard. Downsizing your life to only the things that bring you genuine value. I hope that made sense. How I became a minimalist. Well, I remember sitting on the couch one day in my Nick's apartment back in like, I don't know, 2015, 2016. And I just started looking around and I kind of had a flashback moment from when we first moved in and how empty it was, even with all of our stuff, when we had dropped the boxes for the rooms in each of the rooms. It was like, how are we going to fill up this apartment with these like six boxes, you know? And then just flash forward 6 months later, I'm sitting on the couch and I'm just like, how do we have so much stuff? Like on every surface, there was like neat stacks of just junk, like flyers that you get, shit that comes in the mail that wasn't meant for you, you know, like magazines and just weird stuff that just accumulates. You know, I feel like every time we'd come home, we would come home with something. And then that something just like exists in our house and it just started to like pile up. I was like, what is this? So I went through my closet first because I am proud to say I'm no longer a clothes hoarder, but I used to hoard clothes like crazy. And I love expressing myself through style. So I had a lot of clothes and I still had a lot of clothes from high school and just shirts that I hadn't worn in literally years that always, you know, like the amount of clothes that you have in the closet that once you get down to that amount of clothes, it's like, I need to do laundry because I'm out of clothes. Those clothes, and there were so many, and we had a huge walk-in closet, and the closet was like stuffed between him and I, and I was just like, okay, this is where I'm starting. So I slowly started going through like one sweep at a time. And every time I would do laundry, I would go through the whole closet and I would do a sweep and I would gather up bags full of clothes. And I just keep them in my car because I donate them as I see people that need them throughout town when I'm driving. And that's pretty much how it started. And then we moved. And that really forced us to downsize because you have to go through everything that you own and put it in a box. And then you kind of have to decide, is this something that I want to take with me to the next place or is it not? But as I was doing this, I packed with the intention of minimalism. And when we moved to California for that few months stint, it was like the smallest house I think I've ever seen. It was the cutest little cottage that I've ever seen in my life. And we had to get rid of more things because our stuff just didn't fit. We had like too much dishware and stuff like that, which was just strange. And then that kind of made me realize that there's only two of us living in this house. And when have we really ever entertained anybody? We really just need enough for us. And for me, I knew if we had less dishes, it would help us stay on top of the dishes as well. So I'm thinking of this like reverse engineering my laziness. You know what I mean? Less clothes, less laundry, less dishes. Less dishes. So you go from having a whole bunch of stuff, you don't realize what you're not necessarily using. You go to having a little bit of stuff, then you can really see everything, or at least you know everything that exists and you know what you're using, what you're not using. Come another 6 months later, you can look at the stuff you have now and say, okay, I can cut the fat in these different places. And that's pretty much what we kept doing. And over 2017, we ended up moving 3 times. And each time we moved, we were in a smaller and smaller place. And we had less and less resources to move our things. So we ended up downsizing so much because of circumstance. It was something that I wanted in my life and I knew I had set my intention on it, but it evolved in a way that I didn't expect. I kind of just put it into fate's hands and took my small steps towards downsizing my things. It wasn't like I went through once and was like, okay, we have 2 boxes worth of things now. That's just, I don't think that's entirely healthy. At least it wouldn't be for me, and especially living with somebody else, you have to have respect for their things and what they want too. So slow and steady was how we did it. And honestly, now I'm at the point where in our dresser of, I'd say 5 drawers in total, I have 1.5, and the half is the sock and underwear drawer I share with Nick. And then just 1 drawer where all my bottoms go in. And then in the closet, I have this many. And that's all that I have in terms of clothes. Maybe if you're interested, I can do a what's in my closet video. I've seen those. But yeah, I know that's not a super exciting story, but that's pretty much how we did it. And it was, like I said, slow and steady. I never felt like it was too much, and Nick never felt like it was too much. And now we're at a point where we don't have any desire to really buy anything new. You know, that kind of like transitions us into the next thing that I was going to share, which is just some tips and tricks that I've acquired through this process that have helped me keep going in the right direction. And the first one is to downsize your clothes. Like, figure out what your perfect amount of clothes is with what you have right now. So get rid of everything you don't need. And for me, I'm thinking in terms of how can I make these pieces work in each season. So most of my t-shirts and sweaters are things that can be worn in the winter and also the summertime. Like, for example, this sweater I'm wearing right now, I have a long sleeve shirt underneath it because it's cold, but I could wear this with just like a bralette in the summertime and I wouldn't like sweat or anything. So downsize your closet with strategy. Think, what are the pieces that I feel the best in? The pieces that when they're dirty and I'm trying to get dressed, I'm looking for, because those are the clothes that you're going to wear. And those are the clothes that make you feel good. And then also, what can I keep that I can use and layer and reuse for every single season? Because you don't want to have to be going out and buying more clothes, obviously. So once you get down to your desired closet amount, and that could be a lot or a little, like whatever feels good to you, count your hangers and don't get any more. Easy as that. I have 35 hangers and that covers my tank tops, my crop tops, my t-shirts, my long sleeve shirts, and my jackets. So 35 hangers to Sadie's name. I don't bring anything into my wardrobe that doesn't fit onto those hangers. So that brings me into replace the stuff you have with the stuff that you buy. So don't go out to buy more, go out to buy to replace. And if you have to buy more, then that's fine. Just you know, make sure that it's something that brings you value. There's really no rules. These are just some guidelines that I've followed that kind of help me stay focused with where I'm at and not to lose any progress. So basically, for example, I got And maybe I have a clip. I'll insert it here if I do. I was just gifted a bag of hand-me-downs. And I went through and I found three shirts that I really liked, three crop top t-shirts that I really liked. And I have no hangers, no extra hangers available in my closet. And I refuse to buy new hangers and you know, expand. So what I did instead was found three shirts from my closet that I'm not absolutely in love with anymore. So I'm getting rid of this one, and this one. And then these are my three new shirts. So now I'm going to take the hangers from these shirts, throw those in the donation bag over there, and then this is my new wardrobe addition. Hashtag minimalism. It's like nothing ever happened. You just did like a little swap. I love that. And it's so fun because it's like leveling up. You know what I mean? You don't have to look at the old. You just have like new all the time. And then another thing, and probably the final thing that has really helped is if you're feeling inspired to go a different direction or to buy new equipment or, you know, to get a new jacket or new shoes or whatever it is that you're looking to buy, think for just a second, and this doesn't have to be a long, extensive process, but like allow it to run through your mind. Is this a short term or is this a long term want? Short term being, I just need some change. I'm tired of wearing the same thing over and over again, but I really love the jacket I still have. I'm just gonna buy a new one and I'm just gonna put it on a new hanger. And now I have 36 hangers and that's cool. And that's fine. I'm not saying that's not fine, but that is a short term desire. It might be something that later down the line, you're like, I really don't wear this as much as I thought I would. It was kind of a waste of money or, you know, whatever. Maybe that's not the best example, but hopefully you're following me. And then there's long-term investments where it's like, for example, if I wanted to buy a light kit because it's so freaking orange in here, some reason, if I wanted to buy a light kit, that has a long-term investment for me because it's equipment that I know I can use not only with my videos, but also with our photography and with other freelance gigs that we work on. And so that might be something that I can invest in and that would bring me genuine value for a long period of time. You know what I mean? And that looks different to everybody. So just no matter what it is that you're looking for, is this short-term or is this long-term? And then that kind of just allows you to evaluate what type of value that it's really bringing you and if that's something that you want to invest in. And that's pretty much what I got today. So in terms of minimalism and how we got here and what I do to keep on track, that's pretty much all I have. I am learning every day and I definitely don't feel like a perfect minimalist, but I'm also not really a huge fan of labels. Like, what is a perfect minimalist? I don't know. Do you just have nothing? I don't know. I have no idea. But I know that I live happily in our garage with the few things that we have. I learn every day, I grow every day, and hopefully this video maybe gave you a little bit of an insight to a not so minimalist view of things and can kind of help you get on a track if that track is what you're looking for. If you liked this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Comment down below whatever's on your mind, or if you got any ideas for other videos that you'd like to see or questions that you'd like answered, put them in the comments below. I read everything and I literally thrive off of your guys' feedback, so talk to me. Make sure to subscribe because I do upload new videos every Saturday, and I will see you next week. Peace!